Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to extract contour lines from Google Earth using the QGIS software and the GPS visualizer interface. If you find this video helpful, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe for more GIS tutorials. Contour lines are essential for understanding the topography of an area. They can be used in various fields such as surveying, urban planning, and environmental science. Today, we use QGIS, an open source GIS software, and GPS visualizer, a free online tool, to extract these contours from Google Earth. This becomes important when you have to plan a project you are on and you want to fairly see the topography or the nature of the area. Now, let's get right started. We start by launching our QGIS software with our area of interest. Now, to be able to do this, I'll urge you to watch my previous video which talks about how to download satellite imagery of your area of choosing. Now, we start by creating a regular grid over the area of interest. Now, to do that, you come to Vector, Research Tools, and then we go to Regular Points. Now, there's a pop-up of our regular points, and then this, we go through the various tabs. So we select our input extent for which we want the contour to be done. So from here we select, and then we click on the drop down arrow, and then we select draw over map canvas, and then we select, we left click and hold and hover it onto our area of interest, and then we come to the next tab and we select our space. In that case, we want to use 10 meters, so we enter our 10 meters. And when this is done, we come down to select our coordinate system. After it has been selected, we click on the run tab and then we close. You can see here it has generated a regular grid of 10 meters over our area of interest. Now, this upon creation, we go to, we right click and then we check our attribute table. We realize our elevation data is missing. Now, for any contour work, it is very important to have an elevation point to be able to display the contour. So, to be able to generate our elevation data, we employ the services of the GPS visualizer. To be able to extract our elevation data for the regular grids we created, we first left click on the regular grids, right click, we go to export, save feature as, and then from the format we select a KM or key hole marker language file. Then we select or we rename our regular grid. So we navigate and then we name our file. As a KML file, then we come down here to select our required coordinate system. When this is done, we uncheck the add to save map because we don't want it to reshow on the screen. And then we OK. Click to open the navigation file. Now, after the file has been exported as a KML file, we employ the services of an online elevation marker which is called a GPS visualizer. So to do this, we go into your browser and we type gpsvisualizer.com and then you load. This is the interface that is that results from this, and then we load the interface. Now, to extract the elevations of the regular grids created, go to convert to GPS, and make sure your GPX is selected, and then we navigate to the KML file of the regular grid we just created. Then we navigate to the directory, and then we select the KML file we created. We open to load. Take note, once it's loaded, you have to make sure to select our file and make sure we assign elevation data to it, because if you leave it on no, what happens is after you export, we won't still be having our elevation data. So make sure you come to the bottom of the page and you select and make sure RDM elevation data is selected to the best available source. Now when this is done, we can begin with our conversion process. So we click on convert, and then there's page, it loads, and then we can come and download our GPL file that has been created. So we click on download. It takes a few seconds to download depending on the size. So we navigate to the directory, and once we have our file, we can just move it into our folder to make sure everything Sweden Rich. Okay, once the file has been downloaded, we go back to our QGIS software interface. And then we can drag the file we just created onto the interface. There's a pop-up. Take note that we are only interested in the waypoint which contains the elevation data. As I said earlier, the regular points we generated didn't have the elevation, so we just want the waypoint that contains the elevation. And once we select on it, we click on add layers, and we can see it has been added here. So to confirm that, we select, right click, and then we open the attribute editor. We can see here now that the elevations have been updated with respect to the regular points which didn't have any elevation data. Okay, once we've updated our elevation data, we come to vector and then contour. But if you are using it for the first time, you might not have the contour here. So what you do is you go to plugin, manage and install, and then we can install that contour plugin by searching for that contour. You select on it and then you install. When that is done, you close. So we can come back here to our vector, contour, and then we select our waypoints we just added. Now for the data value, we select elevations, and then we move straight towards to our contour line. From the drop down, we select fixed contour intervals, and then we update the interval we want to use for our drawing. In that case, we want to use 2 meter . So we come down here and we select our precision, and we select color of our choice. And then we add. Now, upon closing, realize we have our contours displayed. Now, to be able to see our contours well, we uncheck the imagery, and then we have our full contours displayed. Now to display our contour interval, we click on the layer labeling option, and when this is displayed, we select our contour layer, and then we go on to select single labels. and then we apply. We can see here our contours have been beautifully labeled. When this is done, we can further export our contour to any third-party software for manipulation. The event we want to send is to AutoCAD. We select the DXF and we name our file. Most importantly, we select our coordinate system and then OK to export. Once the labels have been displayed based on your contour interval, you can quickly load the base map to be able to see the terrain. From here, you can see this side is a hill and it's depicting exactly how the terrain is. So as was said earlier, this is a simple way to be able to create contours and then check yourself for basic plan before you start your actual project. The contour map is now displayed. You can adjust the settings accordingly based on how you want it to look. So that's it, guys. We've successfully extracted contour lines from Google Earth using QGIS and GPS visualizer. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any questions or run into any issues, you feel free to leave a comment below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more GIS videos. Thank you for watching and see you next time. It's bye bye for now.